Hello everyone, welcome. In the previous video, we discussed about that how the Google Docs can be used as a collaborative tool for learning. Now, let us explore some more features that Google Docs provide us. For instance, we as already mentioned that the Google Doc can be prepared in various languages. By clicking on the File tab, scrolling down to the languages, we can select any desired language. For example, to demonstrate here, we'll select Hindi. The moment we selected Hindi, we also have the option of more available here. We click on more, we have four different input tools in which some content can be added in Hindi. For instance, let us select the very first input tool available to us. Through the very first tool, what will happen that we can type any word in English and it will be reflected as such in Hindi. For example, I wrote Namaskar in English and as such, it is being shown in Hindi, Namaskar. So another option of entering some content in Hindi is using Devanagari phonetics. If you click on it, a keyboard will appear in which we can select that what word are we trying to type. For example, I am simply trying to type here Na. So I just clicked on N and then A. And if I click close this keyboard, so this is how my word is being reflected. The third method is the Devanagari inscript, which will show us the keyboard in Hindi. This is more apt for those people who are very comfortable with Hindi typing. Now, the word we want is Naam. So, Na, then A, and then Ma. So, as you can see, Naam word has been added in Hindi. The fourth input method of writing any kind of content in Hindi is by clicking this option. So this will give us a particular board on which we can write in form of a pen. As you can see, this is a kind of a pen appearing. We can simply use the mouse for writing some content. For instance, again, I am writing Naam here. So Google is smart enough to identify that what we are trying to write. So we were trying to write Naam. Now what will happen if I select Naam here, again the word Naam gets inserted. So these were the four basic input tools for typing any content in Hindi. Now in case we want to have any other desired language, we can certainly do that. Again, File, Language, and we can select any language that we are comfortable with. Now let us explore some more features that Google Doc provides us. For instance, now let us talk about the Tools tab available with us. In the Tools tab, another interesting feature is of voice typing. If we select voice typing, we have this mic available and it might ask you permission for enabling the microphone. In case you have such a pop-up, please do allow microphone so that whatever content you are speaking, Google can actually listen to the content and then write it for us. So it's asking us click to speak. It is asking me for permission to use your microphone and I will allow it here. Hello everyone. Welcome. So I haven't typed anything. As you can see, whatever I was speaking has been typed here with minor mistakes. So at least 90% of the work this voice typing feature performs for us. Also, this voice typing feature is available in different languages again. For example, again, let us demonstrate using another language and let us pick up Hindi for that. So again, if I use the voice typing feature, Namaskar. So you can see now it has been typed in Hindi. So this is a very interesting voice typing feature that Google Docs provide us and Microsoft Word doesn't provide. So let us try and explore all the possible features of Google Docs to make our teaching learning process more interactive and more fun for ourselves and for our colleagues as well as for our students. Also, Google Doc provides us some add-on features. That is, if we want to have some specific feature with regards to the content that we are entering, we can use some add-ons. A specific tab of add-ons is present here. For example, for this particular Google Doc, I have already downloaded an add-on by name of Word Cloud Generator. But we can select different add-ons available to us using Get Add-ons. In case we have some add-ons already downloaded in our Google Docs, so we can manage add-ons, that is, we can either uninstall those add-ons. Let us try and explore that how we can select and install the different add-ons available to us from the Get Add-ons button. Now here, as you can see, the different add-ons available are like Lucidchart, MathsType, and the DocuSign, GradeSmarter, Grackle, and different types of add-ons available, which might be useful for making the document more creative and more interactive for the students as well as for our fellow colleagues. Now, for instance, just for trial, let us select the option of teacher rubric here, just to see that how we can install an add-on. Once we click on any kind of add-on, a particular box will appear where it will ask us that do you want to install the particular add-on, and we'll say yes, we want to install the add-on. It will ask us some permissions. Kindly grant all the permissions that it will ask for. Maybe a different Chrome window will appear, again seeking permission that from which account do you want to install the add-on. Now, once we allow and we agree to all the conditions and the permissions that Google asks us for, the add-on gets installed. Now, once the add-on is installed, it can be used in the Google Doc, not just in the Google Doc which we have created just now, but it can be used in different Google Docs that we are going to use in near future as well, unless and until we ourselves uninstall. So here the orange slice, the teacher rubric, has been installed. We can click on done and we can simply cross this add-on option. Now we'll again go back to add-ons and we can see initially it was only Word Cloud Generator. Now we also have here orange slice as teacher rubric available to us. And again, it is available in different languages. So there are different add-ons available which can be explored very conveniently at your own convenience. Now, in case we realize that we had tried a particular add-on, but we do not want that add-on to stay in our Google Docs forever, don't worry at all. We'll just click on Manage Add-ons and it will show us that what particular add-ons have already been pre-installed. So these two were installed. In case you want to uninstall, it is very easy. You click on the options and you can select on only uninstall. Once we click on uninstall, it will ask us some permissions that do you want to uninstall the app. We can simply click on it and the add-on gets uninstalled. So apart from it, Google also provides one feature where some comments can be added to a document. So in case you remember, when we had talked about the share button, we had seen that the sharing can be done in which the person with whom the document is being shared, he or she can either view the document or he or she can comment, and also he or she can edit. Now, this is an option through which we can add a particular comment. As you can see, add a comment. So wherever the cursor has been placed, a comment would be added here. Now, for instance, a student has shared his or her assignment in form of a Google Doc where the faculty member has been invited as a person, as a commenter. So what you can do, whatever place we want that we want to add some comments for our students, we can simply place the cursor at that place, or we can select the respective word and then we can click on add comment and type whatever desired comment we want to leave for our students. So this was all about the different features available about the online collaborative tool of Google Docs. The number of add-ons and number of other features are also available that can be explored at your convenience, at your pace. Thank you so much. Stay tuned for next videos on different topics.